For this video, I'd like to do an example, a very basic example of the central limit theorem. For a sample size of n is equal to 45, find the probability of a sample mean being greater than 551 when mu is equal to 550 and sigma is equal to 3.7. One thing to notice about this problem is that it's asking for the probability for a sample mean. So x bar is our random variable, not an individual x value. In probability notation, this is going to be the probability x bar is greater than 551. The central limit theorem says for sample sizes of at least 30, x bar is going to be normally distributed, meaning it will be bell-shaped, with a mean the same as the original population of individual values, but the standard deviation is always going to be smaller. Specifically, it will be smaller by the original standard deviation divided by the square root of n. Sometimes you'll run across a problem that will give the original population variance. Make sure you take the square root of that to get it in terms of the standard deviation. Now, the central limit theorem says for sufficient sample sizes of at least 30, x bar will be normally distributed with this mean and the standard deviation. And unless this is 0 and this is 1, it's not going to be standard normal. So putting in the values here, we have the mean of the sample means will be 550. And that standard error of the mean, this is also called the standard error of the mean or the standard error, will be equal to the original standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size. Now, we can get a decimal approximation for that. Using my calculator super quick. 3.7 divided by the square root of 45, rounding to 4 decimal places, is about 0.5516. All right, so we have a normal distribution with this mean and the standard deviation. So this is not standard normal. If you want to convert to a z-score and use your standard normal table, you are welcome to. You're going to have to remember to subtract that probability that you get from 1 because we have a greater than situation. I'm going to end up using the TI-84 to do this because I think it's very convenient to use technology. But you definitely want to pay attention to the direction being asked in the probability. And also, you want to pay attention to the wording of the problem. Are you being asked about an individual x value, or are you being asked a question about a sample mean? So if you did want to standardize or convert to a z-score, this is what it would look like. It would be the probability that z is greater than 551 minus 550, that difference divided by 3.7 over the square root of 45. Now the general structure of a z-score is your observation minus the mean divided by a standard deviation. But because we're talking about the sample mean, the distribution of the sample mean, we can't use the original standard deviation. We have to use the standard deviation stated from the central limit theorem. So you could do this, go to your z-table, get the corresponding value, and then subtract that cumulative area from 1 because you're going in the greater than area and the table reads to the left. I'm going to get this probability using the calculator's normal CDF function. Okay, so going to the normal CDF, under my distribution menu, my lower bound in this case is 551. My upper bound is a very large number, so I'm going to put a 1 and a bunch of zeros. Okay, theoretically, it's going to positive infinity, but there is no positive infinity button. Mu is the same as the original populations, 550. Now, for your standard deviation, you could put in the decimal approximation here, or if you are feeling lazy or motivationally inert, you could put in 3.7 divided by the square root of 45 right here, and the calculator will find that standard error of the mean internally. And then we want to paste. So that corresponding probability is pretty small. Rounding to 4 decimal places, that's 0.03491. Okay, so this is the probability that we get a sample mean greater than 551. Now, one thing I didn't do, which is something that I strongly suggest for all examples or all problems, is to sketch the area being asked. Once you get comfortable with this, you can recognize the greater than case, your lower bound is gonna start from 551 and you're gonna go up to a very large number, positive infinity, theoretically. But if you're still a little rusty at this, you can sketch the bell curve. Now, this might be a little bit of a more skinny bell curve because our standard deviation is pretty small. So you can treat this as a visual aid. Our mean is 550, and my value along the horizontal axis that I am concerned with is 551, so that's above the mean. And the greater than case means I want to shade to the right. Okay, so treating this as a visual aid, it tells you that, okay, I expect my area to be less than 0.5 because I'm shading less than half of the bell curve. And then once you actually go through the problem and you get the probability, you can compare it to what you've sketched and recognize the fact that this is definitely not drawn proportionally correct, and that's fine. Okay, I'm just treating this as a visual aid. So clearly this is not 3.5% of this total area.